Dear friends, I welcome you all for the online video lectures about left recursion and left factoring. Before going into this lecture, I would like to introduce myself as Selvi, working as Assistant Professor of CSE Department, Government College of Engineering, Barpur. Left recursion and left factoring are the two major concepts that involving in the compilation by the parser. Let me give you the short recap of parsing. A parsing is the other name of parsing is syntactic analysis, and it is the second phase of the compiler, and it takes the input from the lexical analyzer, and now the syntactic analyzer followed by the semantic analyzer. If you see the compiler, everyone knows about the compiler. Still I am explaining the compiler, about the compiler. Compiler is nothing but one of the translator, which is translating the program which has been written in one language in the form of higher level language into another format. That is nothing but by default it is going to be the lower level language. The compilation process is the lengthiest process. And the process, the entire process is being split into n number of phases. There are totally 6 phases in the compiler. Let me tell you one by one, a short recap of the phases of compiler. Lexical analyzer, syntactic analyzer, semantic analyzer, intermediate code generator, and code generator, and code optimizer. In that we are concentrating the syntax analysis. Why? Because whatever as by nature, if you are speaking in any one of the language, even if it is a English or a Tamil, we are following some set of rules. Based on that rule, either for writing or reading, we are following some rules in the form of a grammar. Likewise, if you are writing a program that is being called as a source program, which has been written either by using the any one of the higher level language, and finally it is going to be parsed, or finally it is going to be understood by the machine. Before we get into this machine, the program is going to be checked by the grammar. So all the languages follows some rules, and all these rules are in the form of grammar, and that grammar here we are called as the context free grammar. So the context free grammar which is being utilized during the compilation by the parser. So parser collects the tokens from the lexical analyzer and starts to build hierarchical structure, and that hierarchical structure called as a parse tree. So during compilation, the parser going to use the context free grammar, and now the context free grammar before parsing it must be verified, or it should be verified for the effective compilation. Why? Because parsing can be done in either two ways, top down parsing or bottom up parsing. Top down parsing takes the source program or start doing the parsing from the grammar symbol and ends with the input sentences, whereas bottom up parsing takes the input sentences and start doing the parsing and ends with the grammar symbols. The main difference between these two parsing is bottom up parsing accepts all kinds of context free grammar. There are no restriction to use a context free grammar, but in the top down parsing there are some restrictions to use a context free grammar. Say the context free grammar should be free of left recursive and ambiguity. There should be no ambiguity. Defining this left recursion, let me give you one example. I have written a grammar. The grammar is made up of the productions. Each and every line said to be a production, and it combines these grammar symbols. The grammar symbols again consisting non-terminals and the terminals, and also it includes some of the symbols also, plus or minus is done, okay? And the nature of this grammar is being used for parsing the statement which involving addition operation, multiplication operation, and the expression is enclosed by the parenthesis, or it can be simply an assignment statement. Now the grammar is in the form of left recursive. How do we find out a grammar said to be a left recursive? If you see the production, the first production, there are totally six productions. Among these six productions, first production and the third production involves the left recursion. How do we find out a left recursive? If we start doing the derivation during compilation, the leftmost symbol of the derivative of the production is being keep on derived by the right side of the production. So if I take the first production, that is E produces E plus T. This is what the start symbol, this is what the first production going to be handled by the top-down parsing. As I said earlier, top-down parsing starts with the grammar symbol and ends with the input sentences. Okay. So in the next step, if you are deriving in the n number of steps, now this E is going to be replaced by either E plus T or by another definition T. If user uses the first alternative, so now E in this step is going to be replaced E plus T and the remaining plus T as it is. We are going to keep it as it is because at each and every derivation only one symbol must be replaced. Okay. So if you keep on deriving it, at one end it's going to be ends with the input sentences, but with a lot of E symbols. Okay. So this is going to be a recursive noun. So this is what the grammar is said to be a recursive. That is, again we are saying that this is the left recursive. That is, the leftmost symbol of the rightmost derivation. Is understood? The leftmost symbol of the rightmost derivation is same as the symbol appears on the left side of the derivation. Is it clear? This is what left side and this is what the right side of the derivation. Here also we can see the E and here also the first symbol, that is the leftmost symbol of the derivation, is going to be the same. So this is what the grammar we can find out, this is as a left recursive. And now the left recursive grammar cannot be handled by the top-down parser. So we need to eliminate it. So in order to eliminate, we have a rule. Okay. So now this is the rule I have written this side. Suppose we have a production in the form of A produces A alpha or beta, then this production can be replaced or can be rewritten as by like this. A produces beta A dash and A dash produces alpha A dash or epsilon. Here in this new production, A dash is the new symbol and epsilon is the empty symbol. Okay. So with this rule, now we are going to substitute, now we are going to eliminate the left recursive from this grammar. So as I said earlier, among the six productions, only that two productions, that is a left recursive. Other productions, we are going to keep it as it is. E produces T as it is, we are going to keep it, and T produces F, this is also correct, no left recursive. And the last production, F produces expression enclosed by the parenthesis, this is also correct, no left recursive occurs. And F and the last production, F produces ID. There is no left recursive. So only in this, the first production and the second, third production, there is a left recursive. So we need to eliminate it. Just we can substitute or we can assume E as A and alpha as the other symbols. After taking out the E, the remaining symbol, that is plus T being assumed as alpha, and the T is going to be the beta. Okay, so now we can apply this rule. We can derive the answer as E produces beta A dash. So now beta is T. A dash. So A dash is nothing but it is a new symbol has been introduced for the grammar symbol A. So here we are going to write it as a E dash. Understood? Now E dash is going to be written as, or the definition for E dash is in the form of alpha A dash. So now alpha is plus T and E dash or epsilon. So the first production, that is a left recursive, and now we have eliminated by introducing three more productions. Okay, and similarly we can take next. T produces F T dash, and T dash produces star F T dash or epsilon. The other productions we are going to keep it as it is because there is no left recursive. Let me check. So this is what now the grammar becomes after eliminating left recursive. And the next concept is left factoring. Left factoring is nothing but, left factoring is nothing but, that is the ambiguity situation arises while selecting the alternatives from the grammar. Let me explain with another example for left factoring. We have a grammar like this. S produces I, E, T, S, or I, E, T, F, E, S, or A, and E produces B. It is nothing but this grammar gives the definition for the if statement for a language, higher level language, maybe a C or a C++. So S is nothing but statement. So the statement can be used to pass if then else X statement. Okay, so I represents if expression then statement, or if expression then statement else statement, or it can be any other statement. Now the expression is going to be the ID. Okay, so if during compilation, if you are doing the parsing by the TauTau parser, there is an ambiguity in the sense confusion while selecting the alternatives. Whether we should choose IETS or IETSES, because there are common terms between the two alternatives, isn't it? So there is an ambiguity. So if such an ambiguity inside a grammar, that grammar cannot be easily handled by the TauTau parser. Okay, so this is going to be, so the grammar is going to be transformed, that is free of the ambiguity. So that grammar is said to be a left factored grammar. So as we said, as we have seen earlier, that is left recursion, to eliminate a left recursion, we got a rule. And similarly for doing the left factoring a grammar, that is a rule. If we have a grammar, if a grammar and the production is in the format A produces alpha beta 1 or alpha beta 2 or up to, it can be n number of terms, that is alpha beta n or gamma, then here I can give you some more detailed production. Alpha, in all the production we can see the symbol alpha. So alpha represents the common term in the production. Common term in the production, and beta represents the remaining term occurs inside of each and every production. Okay, and gamma represents, it is nothing but there is no common term in the productions. Okay, so if such productions involved inside a grammar, So now the grammar can be converted into an equivalent left factorial grammar like this. So A produces alpha A dash or gamma, and A dash is nothing but beta 1, beta 2 up to the beta n. It connects all the other alternatives, other terms from the other alternatives. Okay. Now here also we can see the next new symbol, that is A dash. So if we apply the rule inside this, the grammar, in order to make it as a left factorial grammar, so here alpha is the common term. If expression, then statement, then followed by new grammar symbol. Okay. And the other alternative, that is here A, it doesn't contain any if expression, then statement. So I am writing as it is A. And now S dash is nothing but the other left out term from the alternatives. So E is or epsilon. And third production, there is no common term and there is no need to do a left factorial. Okay. Here you got any you may be getting a doubt in this. Okay. So in this, beta 1 represents the empty, and in this beta 2 represents the ES. Okay, if you are changing this the order, it doesn't going to change the meaning of the grammar. Instead of writing epsilon as the first definition for this symbol, I am writing it in the second alternative. Okay, so this is what the answer. Let me check. So without the help of the eliminating left recursive algorithm and left factoring, you can try this. Whether this grammar has got any left recursive? Please, anyone of you, let me know.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. There is a left recursive, but it is not immediate. Why? Because, as I said earlier, left recursive, the leftmost symbol should be appear at the as a leftmost symbol of the rightmost derivation. So in the first production, there is no such situation in that. But in the second, A produces AC or SD. If we substitute the definition for S in this, now we got a left recursive. A produces AC, and now S is being replaced by the two alternatives. First, I am substituting capital A, small a, and second time I am applying B, D, and third, already we have an epsilon there in the production. So here in this grammar, it involves left recursive, but it is not immediate. Why? Because it is not occurs in the productions which involving the source symbol. This is the main symbol, and this is going to be taken care by the top-down parsing. Not top-down parsing alone. All the parsing. Okay, because this start symbol is going to start the parsing process. Okay. For this lecture, I refer the textbook written by Alfred Avo, Ravi Sethi, and Jeffrey D. Goldman. Thank you all.